Hi, my name is Elisa Benton. This is our team, Team Gray. I'm the facilitator of this team. And Lansa?
I'm Lansa L. I am the team leader.
Hi, my name is Wafa Shatila.
My name is Amar Singh, and I'm the facilitator for this particular team.
My name is Chelsea Miles, and I'm also a facilitator.
All right. So a little bit about our team. Our motto is, we got our team based off the show Grey's Anatomy. So we fix what you can't. And our vision is, our primary purpose as an organization is to deliver high quality information about companies, networks, and technology to help better the company by making their business run more efficiently and effectively. And our mission and purpose is to help facilitate new upgraded hardware and software for our company. The new upgrade system will allow employees to be more productive and efficient. Our goal is to find a vendor that is capable of meeting all requirements and to help ensure that system upgrade runs smoothly for our company and employees. And these are the topics that we will be going over in this presentation.
Okay, we're going to start with our personality traits. My MBTI is an ISFJ, and my DIS personality is a D, which is a dominant trait. My strengths are working with groups, problem solving, knowledge of graphic design. I did the logo that we have, and I have coaching experience.
My name is Chelsea Miles. My MBTI will be ISTP. And my DIS profile is that of an I, which is an influence. Some of my strengths will be that I am task and goal-oriented, tactful and effective in communication, innovative and creative in thinking, and also very motivational.
And my personality is, I am INTP, and my DISC is steadiness. And my strengths are, I'm open-minded and imaginative, enthusiastic, I am the mediator of the group, and I'm honest and straightforward.
My MBTI is ESFJ, and my DISC is compliance. My strengths are basically being really outgoing, I'm collaborative, I'm a hard worker, and I'm very enabling.
My MBTI is ISTJ and the DISC is S. I worked for a company, Ericsson, for 3-4 years in Mumbai. So I have a background of technical computer networking and I have IT experience. I'm a high self-confidence person, so I'm open-minded and I'm very punctual for that.
All right, so we go to our stages of team development. Forming for us was launching our meetings, having a stable environment. We have friendly and cooperative team members. Everybody gets along well with each other. We define our goals, our roles within the team, and we have ground rules that we follow for each meeting and just with our communication going from starting to finish. Our storming stage was when we figured out which communication worked best for us. So using WhatsApp Messenger to communicate throughout the week if we're not meeting was good for us. We have file sharing online, and sometimes we do meet face-to-face at the library. And we haven't had any conflicts so far, and we haven't had an inability to express ourselves or express ideas with each other. Our norming stage, we ask for constructive feedback from everybody in the group, so when we either share a file between each other or whatnot, we ask for each other's thoughts, what we think about it, just to make sure we're all on the same page and have a consensus going forward. And we find that way it's easier to communicate and to make progress going in the right direction. And that way we keep clarified goals for our project going forward. Our GRPR model, our goals, the purpose of our project, we are a consulting firm, and we are actually, for this project, we're working with ourselves. So we found that our actual organization needed to upgrade its hardware and software for us to be more efficient doing our jobs and more effective. The roles, we've already gone over our roles, who's the facilitator and secretary and whatnot. Like I said before, I am the team leader. For our procedures, we have our plans and activities, our milestones, which we'll go over, and the documentation that we'll do from start to finish in the project. And our interactions, we'll go over the team factors, interpersonal relationships, and our agreements.
Team dynamics, meaning evaluation. So for, as you can see here, we have a graph that ranges from each meeting that we've had, and it focuses on organization, communication, and attitude. So with that, for the first graph line, for organization, meeting agenda accomplished and or agreement reached. So that was one of the tasks that we had in that section, and going through and getting that complete was one of the things that we did for organization. For communication, team members show they're welcome to suggestions from one another. There were times where we had at one of the meetings, we were focused in one direction, and there were suggestions that were made in order to bring or make everything make sense, basically, and put it into, we had to end up switching the direction to where it better fit the person who was responsible for that section. It just fit for that person because of their background, knowledge, and skills and experience. For attitude, the members were personable and approachable, valued and supported each other's ideas. And that's something that we've done from the beginning all the way until the present, and we'll carry on that throughout the end of the project.
So this is our good and the bad conflicts, what we went through as a team to kind of get to this point. So our good conflicts were, you know, agreeing on our roles and our responsibilities. You know, so what we did there is to kind of see what everybody's strengths are and what everybody's weaknesses are to define those. Agreeing on the team's mission and logo. We all had different ideas on what our logo should be, and we both agreed that, you know, we all like the show Grey's Anatomy. And so Team Gray definitely fit with us. And making any additional changes to the project. So, you know, we start off with one idea and then we change to a different one, which is, you know, being a consulting firm. And then setting a time schedule. These are our resolutions. Asking all team members to assess their strengths and weaknesses, having everyone give their thoughts and ideas, and assessing the team charter, and assessing everyone's time constraints. So kind of figuring out, you know, everybody works, you know, and trying to figure out what time works well for everybody to meet. And so this is our bad conflicts, meetings where not everyone shows up. So we tried the virtual meeting, and then we had to meet face-to-face. Like I said, everybody works. We found that, you know, being face-to-face works better for us. Unproductive meetings, fear that assigned tasks will not be completed or be compromised by lack of understanding. So it was really just about communication with each of our team members and being able to communicate and have open discussion. These are our lessons learned. Realizing that even though virtual meetings are convenient, face-to-face meetings seem to be more productive. Understanding each of our team's strength and weakness and utilizing these components to our advantage. And being able to communicate effectively and being adaptable to new goals and ideas, and being open-minded to other team members' thoughts, concerns, and ideas.
Okay, I'm going to talk a little bit about our project. So our project is basically, we work to basically replace all the outdated softwares and stuff. So we're going to try to do it in an 8-month period. It'll include network equipment, installation of new data, and new wiring, and new infrastructure, and basically all that good stuff. Our budget is basically $1 million for upgradation of cable, desktop, and storage capacities, routers, switchers, and software. Upgrades will include $1.5 million, and basically this includes all the labor costs and all the budgets and all that good stuff.
So these are the milestones for our project. Like I have mentioned the task name and the duration. The first three milestones are based on the documentation of the existing networks, and the next one is network research, and the last two are based on creating a detailed upgrade plan and implementing that. So we have a deadline for each and every task. I will discuss it later. This is the first milestone. In this particular milestone, our objectives are gaining the understanding of network infrastructure, whatever infrastructure currently we are having in our company. So we have to take a look of that, why it's not performing well or what. So we have to take an idea of our infrastructure and take inventory of current hardware. Whatever hardware is currently available in our company, we have to check the data, the speed, and how many users are using that particular equipment or hardware, like that. So the third objective is we have to form a layout of a network, like how many routers, how many switches, and how many cables or whatever, what type of cables we are using. We have to form a layout of all the existing infrastructure. So this is our first milestone. In second milestone, our objective is gather the network requirements. So we are upgrading a network because we are not getting that much throughput in our network because the customer is increasing. So we have to increase our network capabilities. So according to that, we have to gather the information what we need for the network. Okay. So this is the milestone and this is the deliverables which we are getting after this milestone. We will have a documentation for the network requirements and how much you can say the capability of the network is there for the coming 1, 2, or 3 years. Whenever we are changing the network infrastructure, we should have a clear picture of the capability of the network, how much users can use that particular network, something like that. So we have a clear picture of coming 2-3 years. So this is the milestone 2, and this one is milestone 3. And this particular milestone, we have to determine the number of network which I talked about before. And one more important thing, that we want this particular network at the same place or we want to separate it with the new equipments. So these are the 2 points important in this particular milestone. And we have to check the drops in our infrastructure. Drop means how the user can use this particular infrastructure without getting any error. That is the meaning of drops. So we have to analyze all these things in milestone. And this one is the most important milestone, like network research and design. After getting all the information about the existing infrastructure, we are going ahead with the requirements, what we need for the router and switches, for increasing the speed, cable wire, jumper, server, anything. So these are the objectives for this particular milestone, like research current hardware and capabilities, determine which hardware will be reused, with the new hardware, and research on the new hardware, determine the new hardware, like what will be the cost and what is the requirement, what will be the output of that particular hardware, and finally we have to draw a layout of whole network, like the existing one and the new one. So these are the deliverables of the milestone. After this milestone, we should have a documentation of all the recommended network design and addresses of the IP address, like whatever we want in these objectives. So,
do I need to go back? I'm sorry.
So after this documentation, we have to present all this infrastructure related information to our system administrator, because they are the responsible person who are going to install each and everything. So we should give the presentation regarding that to the system administrator. And that's it. Like we have to be a peer review with all the system administration, like if there is anything wrong or right, so that we can modify all the things. Here it is. That's it. Next. So this is the fifth milestone, creating detailed upgrade plan. As I told you, we have a list of retail equipments which we are going to modify and we are going to buy for the upgradation, and we have to implement that resources, and we have to analyze the person which we are required to implement that, like the labor cost and all. And the deliverables of this particular milestone is we have to upgrade this particular document and whatever infrastructure we need. This is the last milestone. Like, we have created the detailed plan. Now here is the implementation. So whenever we are upgrading any network, we should have some time limit for the upgradation, because at that time any workers might be working in day or night, whenever. Means we can't say that. So we have to define a particular time to upgrade the network. Maybe it's night time or maybe it's daytime, whatever is suitable for the company. So we have to schedule the time for the upgrade, notify the users, and execute our upgrade plan. So the deliverables for this particular milestone is the successful execution of the upgrade plan. So this is the WBS table. Like, we have defined each and every task name, like network upgradation project, verifying existing network, hardware selection, software selection, and the integration of both hardware and software. The training of employees is very much important, because we are including new hardwares and new softwares. So the employees should know about that particular like infrastructures, how they are going to use that. And the deployment by the organization area, like, we have many particular department in our company, so we have to take care of each and every department for this upgradation. And the project management, that's it. So we have defined all the deadlines for our task, like all the milestones and all the work, all the tasks which we are defining in the WBS. So that's our project.